Morning, everybody.
Morning.
God bless you.
Church.
Have a good week. Nice to see everybody. Just a couple things again to remind you of. Again, you can find all these things in the bulletin, which I think y'all got on the way in. If not, they're available on the back table, in the back corner of the room. Again, this coming Saturday, as we've announced, the ladies' mini conference retreat, Cold Springs, from 9:30 to 3:30, with Vicki Bentley. Far-reaching ministries. Again, the cost of that is $45, includes breakfast and lunch. Financial assistance is available for anyone who wants to attend, so don't let the cost deter you from taking part in that. You can still sign up today. These are the sign-up forms. Again, they're in the back corner of the room. And for anybody who would like to take part right after service today, Julie Petrosian is going to have a short prayer session. She invites any of the women in the church who are going to be taking part and would like to take part, would just like to pray for the event, to join her. Again, it'll just be in one of the rooms right after the service, so just find Julie and spend a few minutes in prayer for this event. The Lord would truly use it to change people's lives, and to just affect change, and to let people really know what's happening with this ministry and in South Sudan. So I encourage everybody to be part of that. May 18th at 1:30, it's going to be our baptism service at the Maryland Farms YMCA. Again, that's the one right off Old Hickory Boulevard in the Maryland Farms area of Brentwood, as opposed to the one off Concord Road. So that'll be after church at 1:30. So again, come on out and be a part of that. If you're saved and you have been and you've never been publicly baptized, we invite you to come and do that, to make that public declaration of your faith. And just pray for any who, between now and then, may hear the gospel and may be baptized at that time as well. So, again, that's May 18th coming up in just a few weeks. Last thing to mention again is I've really, really been blessed taking part in the men's evening study that we've mentioned. That we're meeting Tuesdays at 7 p.m. at Panera Bread. Really has been a blessing for me personally. I know it would for other men who've taken part as well. So again, just want to encourage any of the men in the church, come out and join us 7 p.m. on Tuesdays at Panera Bread. We're going through 1 Corinthians right now, just digging really deep and really learning a lot about the Word. And Lord has just provided a lot of great insights. So all the fellows in the church, if you have the occasion, the opportunity, please come out and join us at 7 on Tuesdays at Panera. All right, that said, before we worship, I want to invite you to stand with me, and let's read together from Psalm 118. I'd like to read Psalm 18, the last two verses, verses 28 through 29, as we prepare our hearts to worship this morning. Verse 28 says, "You are my God, and I will praise you. You are my God, I will exalt you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever." Let's pray. Lord, we do give you thanks and exalt your name this morning. Father, we thank you that your love is everlasting, that your grace is sufficient, Lord, that your love endures forever. Father, we thank you for bringing us to this place. Thank you for the liberty we have to just worship you and bring glory to your name, Lord. Pray that all our efforts would be on your behalf, Father. Pray that you would be better known to all of us today as a result of our time in worship and in study. Lord, we pray for those who couldn't be here. We pray for those who are traveling. Lord, we lift up Sandra Tullis, who is recovering from minor surgery, Lord. Pray that you would keep her safe. Again, Lord, all those who couldn't be there, we just pray that you'd be with them, bring them back safely. Lord, now just turn our hearts and our minds fully towards you. Lord, we thank you again for all the ways that you've loved us, all the ways that you provide for us. Lord, for your creation. Lord, just for this opportunity to come back and be close to you. Lord, again, let all this be for your glory, for your honor, as we praise your name this morning. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Jesus.
You are the one we adore. Together, all together, Lord. In the morning when I rise, so gracious, and you've taken our hearts, Lord, and changed them and made them new, and put a hope in us, Lord, that is everlasting and unquenchable, unfadable, Lord. You're one who has promised us great and precious promises, Lord, and we didn't deserve any of that. And so we thank you and we praise you for your grace. We thank you that you are kind beyond words. And Lord, we, on one hand, sit in awe of your majesty and your righteousness, and at the same time, we're completely blown away by the fact that, in spite of all that you are, you reached down into our lives and took hold of us and changed us. Thank you, Lord, for these things. And Father, at the end of it all, at the end of the day, at the end of all of our days, if we have nothing else, we have Jesus. Thank you that he's enough. We praise you, Father, and ask that you bless our time as we open your word this morning. I pray that our hearts and our minds would be open and ready to receive what you'd say to us. We desire, Lord, to meet with you here in this place. We desire to hear your voice. So speak to us, Lord, and guide us by your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name. Amen. Would you all take a moment and say hello to the Lord?